Well, this is a scary thought. Data thieves know where we are, the websites we surf, and how to get our credit card numbers.
But as David Wade discovered, there are concrete things that you can do to prevent your information from falling into the wrong hands.
Oh my gosh, yeah. It's got me all over the city.
Maybe it shouldn't come as a shock, but your iPhone is tracking where you've been and when you were there.
Walpole, Boston, Foxborough.
We stop people and show them a location feature that you have to press 5 buttons to find.
It's creepily specific.
You should look at your phone settings and understand who you're sharing location data with.
Lee Weiner is a senior VP at Rapid7. That's a cybersecurity company. While you need to give up your location for your GPS to work, you don't need to for a ton of apps that all seem to want it.
Maybe it's a music streaming service or a radio service that you have. You don't necessarily need to share your location data.
Weiner says it's important to check all your apps.
Certain applications, if you feel don't need that, just disable it.
Then there are passwords, passwords, and more passwords. One of the biggest mistakes we make is using the same one over and over again, which makes it very easy for hackers to steal it.
Your information has value on black markets. So if I can steal your username and your password, I can sell that.
But who can come up with multiple complex passwords and have a chance of remembering them? Web technology to the rescue.
It's like a password vault.
You create a master password and the technology remembers everything else. But couldn't that get hacked?
Could be, though the benefit outweighs the risk.
For online shoppers, the best advice is to not allow websites to store your credit card, which means you have to fill out all the forms each time you buy.
I know it's a bit of an inconvenience, but the return on that is high.
And privacy settings on social media can change as new services are added. So it's a good idea to check every couple of months to make sure they're what you want. And the stakes are high. Think identity theft and credit card fraud.
You can protect yourself by limiting the amount of data you store.
Another good idea is to use something called two-factor authentication for your most sensitive online services. That pairs a password with a randomly generated number that you receive as a text. Again, less convenient, but safer. Go to our website, cbsboston.com, and you can review this information and get more details. I'm David Wade, WBZ News.